This is how to get the heat of water when it undergoes phase changes. Our question is, how much heat must be supplied to 135 grams of ice at minus 14 degrees Celsius to convert it to steam at 185 degrees Celsius? And we're given lots of specific heats and also heats of fusion. Okay, this is going to take us 5 steps. First, we're going to have ice at minus 14 degrees Celsius, and we will need to convert it to ice at 0 degrees Celsius, because it just won't melt unless it's at 0 degrees Celsius. Then we're going to have to take ice at 0 degrees Celsius and make liquid water, water the liquid, at 0 degrees Celsius. I'll write all down here so maybe you can remember that it's liquid. Okay. Then we need to take water in the liquid state at 0 degrees Celsius and get it up to water in the liquid state at 100 degrees Celsius. Finally, we need to do another phase change, so this would be water at 100 degrees Celsius in the liquid state, and we need to convert it to steam at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, now we're finally to steam. Now we just need to take steam at 100 degrees Celsius and convert it to steam at 185 degrees Celsius. Okay, those are all the steps that we need to do. So it's 5 separate problems. All right, we'll start with ice. Changing the temperature of ice is going to be equal to MS delta T. Our mass of material is 135 grams. The specific heat of ice is 2 joules per gram degrees Celsius, and going from minus 14 to 0 gives us a delta T of 14 degrees Celsius. So I will multiply that out. My answer comes out to be 3,780 joules for that answer. Now, since I know the other answers are going to wind up in kilojoules, I think it's important that I get them in a state where we can actually add them. So I will get this as 3.780 kilojoules, and I'll just put a box around it so I can easily spot it later. I'm going to need that value. Okay, the next item is a phase change, and the heat associated with a phase change is equal to the number of moles times the heat of fusion, because we are going from ice to liquid water. So that's the heat of fusion for that one. So I will need to take my 135 grams of water and divide by the molar mass of water, which is 18.02 grams of water per 1 mole of water, and multiply it by the heat of fusion, which turns out to be 6.01 kilojoules per mole of water. So I will type that into my calculator. And that answer comes out to be 45.02 kilojoules. So I'll put a box around that one so I can spot it easily. Okay, next one is back to changing the temperature of one substance. So the heat involved is going to be MS delta T. My mass of water is 135 grams. We're dealing with liquid water now. So the specific heat of that is going to be 4.2 joules per gram degrees Celsius. And we are going all the way from 0 to 100 degrees. So my delta T will be 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, into the calculator we go. And my answer comes out to be 56,700 joules. Once again, I will convert that to kilojoules, so that'd be 56.70 kilojoules. Put a box around that one. Okay, we're 3/5 of the way done. Now we need to go from liquid water to vaporous water, steam. So Q is equal to N, this time times the heat of vaporization. So I will take my 135 grams water. I will figure out the moles of water by dividing by the molar mass. And this time I will multiply it by the delta H of vaporization, which turns out to be 40.7 kilojoules per mole. And that turns out to be 304.91 kilojoules. All right. Last calculation, changing the temperature of the steam. That's going to be MS delta T. I have 135 grams of water. The specific heat of the steam is 2 joules per gram degree Celsius. And I'm trying to get from 100 to 185. So the temperature difference there would be 85 degrees Celsius. This turns out to be 22,950 joules, or 22.95 kilojoules. Okay, now it's just a matter of adding each step. So we've got 3.78 plus 45.02 plus 56.70 plus 304.91 plus 22.95. Now, thinking about the number of sig figs that all of these are good to, each one is only going to be good to, let's see, that's only good to 2 sig figs for a specific heat of ice or vapor. So that's really only good to that value. And my vapor is only good to the 1s digit. My specific heat of water is also only good to 2 sig figs. Oh boy. Okay, so technically it looks like only good to the 10s digit by the time I add these all up. And by the time I'm all done, it looks like it adds up to 433.36. And I'm actually going to take one thing back on the sig figs. These two are actually dependent on the grams. Let's see, absolute value of the temperature changes. Yeah, that should be good. So these two are actually good to 135 grams. So that's actually good to 3 sig figs there and 3 sig figs there. So I am actually good to the 1 stitch. So I can report this as 433 kilojoules. Okay. That's how to get all the way there.